What's up, everyone, and welcome to the club. In today's video, we're creating a sketch illustration of Miles Morales as Spider-Man. Let's begin today's drawing by sketching a circle in the center of our page. We move to a side grip, sketching with a flat edge. Let's start at the very top in the middle. Just going to lightly work our way around the left side. And then bring that back in towards the middle. And we'll go all the way around the right side. Now from here, we're going to sketch a straight line coming down the center of our page. Starting from the top of our circle, sketch that line coming all the way down towards the bottom, and we'll extend that up towards the top. Let's add another guideline going across the center from left to right. Starting right in the middle of our circle, extend this out towards the left, and then the right side. And then we'll go out to the side of our circle, curve the bottom of the head, coming down, and then bending that in towards that center line, and then go out and up on the right side. Now that we've drawn the shape of our head, let's add in the eyes. Leaving a gap in the center, on the bottom of our circle, step over toward the left, curve the eye going up, and then bend that out toward that center line, go over towards the right, and do the same thing. Now I'm going to round out the bottom of the eye. Starting from the inside of the left eye, curve this down, and then bend that up towards the side of the head. Now from here, we're going to wrap the hood around the head. From the top of our circle, let's step down, curve this out around the eye, and then down towards the side. Now going back up to the top, we're going to curve this down across the right eye, and then out towards the same height. Let's go back to the left side. We're just going to round out the hood, coming down, and just pull that up on the left side of the chin. Let's go to the right side and do the same thing. Just going to round this out, and then pull that in. Let's add a fold on the side of the hood. Starting on the left side, we're just going to curve this up and in towards the top of the circle. Go to the right side, curve this down, and then out. Now we're going to extend the top of the head. Starting over on the left side, stepping out, go straight up, and then we'll just bend that in towards the middle, go out, and then down on the right. Now that we've blocked in the head, let's move out to the side and draw two large circles for the shoulder. We start on the left side of the head, go all the way around, towards the side, and then pull that back up. Let's go over towards the right side and draw that same size circle, coming down towards the same height, going up towards the top, and then down on the side. From the outside of the shoulder, we're going to curve the arms coming down, and then bending that in towards the bottom of our page. Now from here, we're going to cross the arms in the center of the body. Right where the hood meets the shoulder, so right here, I'm going to angle this down, cross the center, and then out towards the right. Go to the right side and do the same thing. Now I'm going to go back up to the top of the line, draw a straight angle line coming down and out. And we'll follow that same angle line coming down in towards the middle. Now from here, we're going to extend the hands out towards the side. We'll start from this point, follow that same angle line, going up and out past the side of the shoulder. And then from the bottom of the wrist, we're just going to flatten out that line, going out towards the side. Halfway between the tip of this line and the wrist, so starting right here, we're just going to angle this down and then out. Let's flatten off the tip of each finger with a short line. And we'll follow that same angled line coming back in towards the hand. Now from here, we're gonna point the thumbs going up. Starting from the top of the wrist, start with a short line going up towards the thumb. And then from here, we're gonna curve the thumb going out and then up. From the tip of the thumb, curve this out and then in. Now round out the bottom and then pull that back out towards the top of the hand. Now that we have our basic pose, we'll go back and lightly erase some of these guidelines. Once we're happy with the general proportions, we'll go back and add a second level of detail. Let's round out the cuff from this line, coming down towards the bottom, and rounding out the top. And then from this curve, we'll step down and draw that again. Let's curl the bottom of the hood coming back down, starting in here, rounding out the top, and then coming straight down in behind the arms. Let's add a fold along the inside of the hood going on top of the head, starting on the left, going up across the head, and then bending that out. Do the same thing on the right. Now let's go in with the tip of our pencil and lightly trace out our contours and add a little bit more detail. We start with the overlapping elements first, starting with the arms on the left, starting from the bottom of the cuff, and trace this out, and just overlap this on top of the cuff. So extend this out on the top and bottom. And then we're gonna overlap the left arm on top of the right. So starting in here, just gonna go extend this out past the side of that line, and then adding a fold, and then bringing that down. And then we'll tuck the right arm in behind. Now adding some shape to the cuff. Now I'm going to add some shape to the left hand. Going up towards the thumb. And rounding out the knuckle. And then going up towards the tip. I'm just going to extend the thumb up a little bit higher. Let's work our way out towards the first finger. Just going to round out the tip and bring that back down. I'm going to add two bumps for the knuckles along the inside, going out towards the bottom finger. Add a curve along the base of the bottom and first finger. As well as the thumb. Now with the hands in place, we can go back and start detailing out the hood. Going all the way around, in behind the hand. Then add that fold on the top. Then working our way up towards the top of the head. Just adding that fold on top of the head, and then tucking the head in behind the collar and the hood. Now we're going to go back and start detailing out the eyes. Start by tracing out the contour. And we're trying to stay loose at this stage. Come back and add some details after. And we'll add that thick trim along the inside of the eyes. Now we're going to go ahead and start adding the webbing, starting in between the eyes. And just lightly trace out the webs. I'm just going to add some webs across the fingers. Now we're going to add a light shade to the entire body. Now this process is going to also help remove some of those guidelines. And I'm going to go back and start darkening up the blue areas of the body, starting with the gloves. Just going to separate the blue and the red areas of the costume. So fill in the shoulders and arms. Let's add a seam on the inside of that zipper. And we'll darken up the outside. And now we're going to go back and refine the contrast and details. Now to give our drawing some depth and shape, we're going to start adding some various tones with the shadows. Starting with the inside of the hood, and darken this up, and then fade that out as you come down and out. Darken up the top of the head, where the hood's going to cast a shadow, and fade that out. Now you want to pull the head forward, so we're going to darken up the shadow along the top of the body, just underneath the head. And then again, we're just going to fade that out towards the bottom. I'm just going to leave a little bit of a highlight along the outside edge of the hood. And we'll darken up that center seam and work our way down towards the right. Now we're going to go back and redraw those web lines. just going to add a little bit of reflection to the outside trim of the eyes. And then shading the outside of the eyes and then fading that in. And we're going to add some shading to the hands and arms. Now the hood is going to cast a shadow across the body, so darken this up and then fade that down. And as we get closer to the end of our drawing, we'll tighten up our shadows and add a little bit more contrast. And that's pretty much it. There's a sketch illustration of Miles Morales. Now, if you enjoyed today's lesson and you want to elevate your drawing skills, this video right here will help you do just that. I draw every single day and I've seen a huge improvement in my techniques and results. So remember to leave a like and I'll see you in the next one.